Hello everyone, Marine here for Lanfun. Thank you for joining me today on this new video. A video that features two shark pirates who have found a treasure hidden in a cave deep down in the ocean. So those sharks are from Dunner and Dunner Flip Flop. And to build this underwater scene, I used a bunch of other sets. I like you a little for the seaweed, ocean shelfie for some rocks, more seaweeds and rocks from You Are Sublime, a tropical leaf from To Can Do It, the eye patch and pirate hat from Booyah, another seaweed from Fantastic Friends, the treasure chest, map, diamond and coins from Ahoy Matey, more leaves from Critters Down Under, I picked the rock, tiny fish and starfish from Mermaid For You, and for the die sets, I used the Magic Iris and the Addon, the second and third die from Stitched Dance, the largest stitched rectangle, and a stitched wavy border to ground my scene. So here we have all my cute images ready to be colored. As always, I stamped them all using Lanfun Jet Black ink and cut everything using the coordinating dies. After the coloring, I created the cave. I cut 3 panels using the Magic Iris add-on, and from the left to the right, the papers are Rainforest, Peacock, and Mermaid. I kept the middle circle with the Rainforest panel, and then I did some die cutting on the 2 other panels to build the cave. I took the second die from Stitched Dance and placed that die in the middle of the Peacock panel. I taped the die and sent the panel to my die cut machine. And here we have our first cave element that will go on the Rainforest panel. Next, I took the third die from Stitched Dance and did the same thing with the Mermaid panel. I taped the die in the middle of the panel and sent it to my die cutting machine to create another cave element. And to ground my scene, I cut a piece of vanilla malt paper using the Magic Iris add-on. And from that piece, I cut a wavy border. So here's the basic background. You could definitely skip the next part, but I personally like to add shadows and contrast and texture to my cards. So I used distress inks to bring more depth to those cave panels. I picked 3 colors matching the papers and applied the inks on the outside and inside edges for the mermaid panel and on the inside edges only for the 2 other panels. And for the wavy border, I turned it into a sand border using anti-linen distress ink first, and then vintage photo to darken it a little bit. And off-screen, I added a tiny bit of texture on the 3 panels and sand border using the same inks mixed with water. And I just added an extra detail to the sand border using white acrylic paint with water. And here my background elements are all done. So next, I moved on to the interactive part and I cut 3 wings, 3 sausage pieces, 2 tabs, all out of Rainforest cardstock. And on the rings and sausage pieces, I added some pine needle distress ink to match the background. And I also cut 3 stabilizers out of scrap paper. I took one of the rings and started by cutting 3 holes and 3 stitch brackets out of this ring using the flux capacitor die. I taped the die in the middle of the ring and sent it to my die cutting machine. Next, I put 1 sausage piece in a hole. I lined it up with the ring and kept it in place using a clothespin. I did the same thing with the 2 other sausage pieces. Put each one of them in a hole, lined them up with the ring, and used clothespins to keep everything together. Each sausage element has an X mark on the rounded edge. This is where I stuck a small glue dot, 1 glue dot on each X mark. I took a second ring that I placed and lined up on top of the sausages. I pressed down to stick that second ring to the 3 glue dots, and then I removed the pins. I flipped the whole element over, and right on the bracket spots, I applied double-sided sticky tape. So I applied the tape on the brackets, I removed the backing papers, and then I stuck the stabilizers on those spots, just by lining up the curved end of the stabilizer with the inside circle of the ring. Once again, I flipped the whole ring element over, and then I stuck both tabs together. I didn't do this on my very first Magic Iris cards, but gluing 2 tabs together makes the thing more sturdy. So I attached this tab next to a stabilizer, stuck it on the right. I peeled the backing papers of the stabilizers, placed the last ring on top. I made sure that everything was lined up. And then I folded the stabilizers on that last ring to totally complete the magical wreath. And I didn't fold those stabilizers too tight or the mechanism won't work. I tested it a few times to make the opening and closing more smooth. And next, I glued the arrow handle on the tab. I just placed it right up against the rounded edge of the ring and I trimmed off the tab. Next, I applied double-sided tape on the stabilizers and all over the ring. And I'm noticing just now that I forgot to peel off one backing paper. I placed the magical wreath behind the rainforest panel. I lined up the tab with the notch and the iris with the circle. And I pressed down firmly to connect everything. Off screen, I applied foam tape at the back of the two other panels. And I stuck those panels on top of each other. The peacock panel on top of the rainforest background and the mermaid panel on top of the peacock. And to totally complete my background, I attached the sand border at the bottom using double-sided tape. I flipped the panel over and applied double-sided tape on the stabilizers only, as well as 2mm foam squares all around the ring. And I attached my magical wreath panel on top of a shimmery pink panel. I chose this pink paper to coordinate with the diamond. Next, I opened the iris and applied liquid glue at the back of the rainforest circle, and I tucked that circle right in the center of the iris. And then I finally filled the cave background with all the images. And to be able to close the iris, I needed the images inside the circle to stay flat. So I used liquid glue to stuck those images, and for the other images on the card, I also used glue dots. Once everything was attached, I added white highlights and details to the images. I attached my panel on a sugar plum panel that I stuck on a sugar plum card base. And the last final details, I cut the arrow handle a second time out of sugar plum paper. And I stuck the small arrow on the magic iris handle. And I also white heat embossed my sentiment, "You are just some," on cilantro cardstock. I chose this paper to match some green elements on the card. And I trimmed it into a small banner that I attached right above the cave. And that's it. This is the final result. We have two cute and friendly shark pirates who have found a mysterious treasure. And I think that you can see all the white details, the dots that I added to the diamond and coins. It really looks like everything is shining when you open the iris. Well, I hope that you like this new card. A huge thank you for your support. I will see you in the next video. Have a good day. Bye.